Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and probably most of us as graphic designers are using Instagram to post our work from time to time. And at least for me, trying to type and post on a phone is just a pain. So today I'm going to show you how to post on Instagram using Google Chrome on a Windows or Mac. And there's also an issue you might run into where you can't post a PNG file, but I'll show you a workaround for that. All right, let's get started. Okay, so first we'll open Google Chrome and we'll go to Instagram.com. And you'll notice when you scroll down that you don't see any buttons like you normally do on a phone. So there's really nothing to post with here. So to get those to show up, we're going to have to change our view to the phone view. And to do that, on a Mac, you'll press Option, Command, and I. On a PC, it's Shift, Control, and J. And this will bring all this crazy coding stuff. You don't have to worry about this, but it looks like a bunch of gobbledygook. In this window in the upper left, you're going to look for this little icon that's the little toggle device toolbar image, and we'll click that. For me, I've got it set to the iPhone 10 right now. If you click this little triangle, you'll see some options, and iPhone 10 works pretty well. So you can go ahead and click that one. But you'll notice if you scroll down, you still don't have those little buttons anymore. So to get to those, you'll need to refresh your page. On a Mac, you can just hit Command R or Shift Command R to refresh. And if you're on a PC, you can hit F5. You can also just come up here to this little arrow and click refresh. And now your buttons will be right down here like they are on your phone. And you can hit the plus button to add a new post. Okay, so I've got an Instagram picture ready that I want to post, and you can see that it's grayed out here. So it ends in PNG, everything looks fine, except we can't actually select it. So to fix this, come down here to Options, and then instead of Custom Files, choose All Files. And this will give us the option to select it. By the way, for whatever reason, this doesn't happen with a JPEG, so it should always be able to be selected. You don't have to come down here to Options and choose All Files for JPEG files. So anyway, we'll open this. You probably have noticed that your cursor is now a round dot, but that's fine. It works just the same as a mouse. It's trying to emulate tapping instead of clicking or whatever. So anyway, I've got my new picture uploaded. I'll click Next, and then I'll write a caption here like I normally would. I'll just put, come and take a look at my new YouTube channel, Finance on the Offense. And then we can add hashtags. So I'll just put personal finance, finance, YouTube, and education. And now I'm ready to share. So I'll click the share button and that's it. And now once you're done posting on Instagram like this, you can go ahead and close your developer tools and it'll resize your screen back to normal, but you'll still have the add button if you want to add some more posts to Instagram. Now, if you refresh at this point, it'll go back to that old screen and your buttons will be gone. So just keep that in mind. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button and I'll see you in a couple days with another graphic design tutorial. Thank you.